And good morning everyone. Today we will do one more numerical on the topic cable subjected to UDL. So the numerical is, find the maximum possible span for a cable supported at the ends at the same level, allowing a central dip of 1 by 10th of the span and a permissible stress of 150 newton per mm square. Steel weighs 78,000 newton per cubic meters. Assume that the cable takes a parabolic profile. So in the question, we have to find the maximum possible span that can be provided for a cable, keeping in mind the central dip as 1 by 10th of the span, if the permissible stress of the cable is 150 newton per mm square. See, by permissible stress, we mean to say that the maximum stress which can be beared by the cable. If the stress in the cable exceeds this value, the cable will fail. It is also given that the unit weight of the steel is 78,000 newton per cubic meters. Now in the question, you can see that there is no load acting on the cable. So the only load acting on the cable is its self weight. And the self weight of any body is assumed to be acting as a UDL. And in the previous derivation, we found out that whenever a UDL acts on a cable, the profile of the cable is a parabolic profile. And it is also given in the question that assume that the cable takes a parabolic profile. So now let us continue with the solution. So it is given that the dip, that is the value of small h, is 1 by 10th of the span. So it means L by 10. From here I can find out the ratio of h by L, which will come out to be 1 by 10. Now in the previous derivation, we found out the length of the parabolic cable. So the length was L plus 8H square by 3L, by 3L. From here I can take out L as common, with which I will be left with this term inside the bracket. Now I know the value of H by L, so by putting H by L as 1 by 10, I will get the total length of the cable as 308 by 300 into L, small L. Small L is the span of the cable. Now let us consider that the area of the cable is capital A mm square. See, now we will have to find out the weight of the cable. The weight of the cable can be found out by multiplying the volume of the cable with the unit weight. See, the unit of the unit weight is newton per cubic meters. So if I multiply the unit weight with the volume, I will be left with newtons, that is weight. So in order to get the weight of the cable, we multiply the unit weight with the volume of the cable, and the volume of the cable will be what? Cross sectional area into the length of the cable. Okay, so the cross sectional area we have assumed in mm square, but the unit weight of the steel cable is given in newton per cubic meters. So we will have to convert the cross sectional area in meter square. So mm square can be converted into meter square by dividing it by 1000 whole square. So area of cross section into the length of the cable, which was found out to be 308 by 300 into L. By solving this, I will get the total weight of the cable as 0.08008 AL newtons. In the previous numerical, in the previous derivation also, we found out that each vertical reaction is equal to WL by 2. See, WL, we are multiplying the UDL with the length, and when we multiply the UDL with the length, we get a point load. So suppose W into L is capital W, so we can write it as capital W by 2. We also know that the value of capital H, that is the horizontal thrust acting on the tower, acting on the support, that is the that is the point of contact between the cable and the tower, is WL square by 8H. See, I can write WL square as WL into L. Again, WL can be written as capital W. So this equation can be written as capital W into small L by 8H. Now L by H, we know the ratio is 10. H by L was 1 by 10, so L by H will be 10. So from here we will get the value of capital H as 5 by W into capital W. Now we know that the maximum tension is T max equal to under root V square plus H square. Putting all the values of V and H, we will get the value of T max as 1.35 capital W. So after putting the value of capital W, I will get this equation of T max. Now we are given in the question that the maximum permissible stress in the cable is 150 Newton per mm square. So maximum stress means, see, stress is what? Force upon area. So force is T max. See, if I put the value of T max in the equation, I will get maximum stress. If I put the value of minimum T minimum, I will get minimum stress. But in the question we are given the value of permissible stress, and that is the value of the maximum stress. So in order to get the maximum stress, I will put T max. So from here, F max is 150, put the value of T max, which we found out here. Capital A, keep it as it is. So from here, we can find out the value of small L, which is 1387.5 meters. So the maximum span of the cable, which we can provide, keeping in mind that the central dip should not exceed 1 by 10th of the span, is 1387.5 meters.